So, good morning, students. So, once again, we came to that is a new chapter, inverse trigonometry function. Yesterday, we have discussed about that is a so sine, cos, tan. So, still three functions are there, and this is very important, which we have already discussed this or studied in the first year. That is the domain and range of the trigonometry function. Let we list all that. Sine is a functioning from where to where? R to minus 1 to 1. It is a closed interval. So domain of the sine function is R and range of the sine function is minus 1 to 1. Similarly, cos, its a domain is real number and its range is minus 1 to 1. And tan is a functioning from R minus. So this for an angle, so multiple of odd multiple of right angle, so our tan function is not defined. So a domain of the function means collection of all the real number for which our tan function is real. So for these numbers our tan function is not real, so we will eliminate for that sake our real number r minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2, where n belongs to z, will become the domain of the tan, and similarly r is the range. For a chord, r minus n pi, n belongs to z to r. So it is the domain of the chord function and range is real number sec. So r minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2, n belongs to z. So r minus minus 1 to 1. So this is a domain and range of the function. Similarly, cos r minus n pi, n belongs to z to r minus minus 1 to 1. So these are the things which we have already studied in the first year. So we have to study that is the inverse of this function. So inverse of this function. So we have already discussed that is the sine, inverse of the sine function. So whether inverse, if you want to study that is the inverse of a trigonometry function means, first when the trigonometry function has its inverse. So any function has its inverse only when it is a invertible. If it is a invertible function, then it has its inverse. So now we have to check whether these trigonometry function, that is sine, cos, tan, sec, cot, sec, cosec, whether these are so invertible or not, we have to. So when they will become a invertible? If they are invertible function, then they have its inverse, and we define its inverse. We know already, we have studied in the previous that chapter, the relation and function. Using that concept, so we are discussing that is the inverse trigonometry. So first, whether the sine becomes from the domain to range, we have that is the real numbers to the minus 1. Whether in this domain, our sine function is 1, 1 or not, we have to check. So invertible function means, so it should be a both 1, 1 and on 2, then we say it is an invertible function. So if it is an invertible, then it has its inverse. So first, yesterday we have discussed about that is a sine function, cos function and also about the tan function. Let me recall once again. So if we take the whole real number domain, so it is not a 1, 1. Why? Because I will show the simple example, that is the sine. So that is pi by 4 is equal to what we have? Sine pi by 4 is 1 by root 2. So next we have that is a sine 5 pi by 4 is also 1 by root 2. Is also 1 by root 2. So both are different. Pi by 4 is different from 5 pi by 4. But they got the same value. Images are equal. Sine of pi by 4 is equal to sine of 5 pi by 4. For a different value, we got the same image. Therefore, our function is not a 1, 1. Our function is not a 1, 1 for a real number. then what we have to do? If the function is not a one-one, so how can it becomes the invertible? So first we have to restrict our domain. Whether after restricting our domain, whether it will become a one-one or not, we have to check. So for that we have a simple logical arrangement. So we know the graph. Through the graphically also we can analyze, that is the whether the function at which interval it will become a one-one or not. So we know already the graph of the sine function. So it will takes like this. The graph of the sine function. It is a 0 and it is a pi by 2. It is pi and it is 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. Similarly here, that is minus pi by 2, minus pi, minus 3 pi by 2. And this is the minus 2 pi. So this is the nature of, that is a sine function, normal sine function. So now we have to know whether at which interval it will become the 1-1 function. So through the graphically also we can easily analyze whether it will become a 1-1 or not. Simple, that if you draw, that is a straight line parallel to the x-axis. If a curve cut by that straight line more than one point, then it is not a 1-1. So here we have to divide this real number into the sub interval. So at which interval our sine function becomes 1-1 or not? Yaar interval dalaga a sine function yen agutandre 1-1 agutha a interval na divide madu. So let me start with that. Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So here it cuts only one point, that straight line. Similarly, here pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, it cuts only one point. So here also from pi by 2, minus pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. If you take here, it will cuts two points. But for that reason, so in these reason, our function becomes 1-1. So for these intervals, so our function is both 1-1 and onto. Why it becomes onto? Because a range of the function is a codomain. Range of the sine function itself is a codomain. For that reason, our sine function is so invertible in these interval. So then we have to change its domain. Then only it will become a both 1-1 and onto. What is its domain? That is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 at these interval. Not for only these interval, we have so many interval. So we have a branches of the intervals. So at which our sine function is both 1-1 and onto. So it one day interval alri hinta intervals balastu da nam real number line daga aa ella interval alli nam sine function enagagutte 1-1 ಮತ್ತು ಆನ್ ಟು ಎರಡು ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇದು 1-1 ಆನ್ ಟು ಆಯ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಬಲ್. ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಬಲ್ ಇತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಿರ್ತೈತ್ರಿ? ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ. ಆ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ನ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ದ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್, ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೈನ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ is a functioning from. How we define? We reverse, that is the codomain to the domain. It is a functioning from. Sine inverse x is a functioning from minus 1 to 1 to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Pi by 2 to pi by 2. So not only for this, so we have so many functions which has its inverse. So which we can write like this also, sine inverse 1 to pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. So in this interval also our function is invertible, that is the pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. So at this interval it will become a 1-1 and onto. So this is called as inverse of. So here we state that instead of writing all the interval, we'll select one interval, that is the so minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, which we call it as a principal branch. of these interval, principal branch of the sine inverse x. So these all are called as the ranges of the inverse function. Ranges of the inverse function. What is the range of that is the sine inverse x is nothing but the minus pi by 2 to 2, pi by 2 also, pi by 2 to 2, 3 pi by 2. These all are called as the ranges of the given sine inverse x. Instead of writing all the ranges, we have stated this is called as a principal branch range, minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, which we call it as a principal branch range of that is a sine inverse x. So instead of taking all the interval, we have selected only one interval, that is minus pi by 2 to pi, which we call it as a principal branch range. So, and how we get that is a graph of this. So that is a reverse of this. So we will get the graph for the sine inverse like this. For a sine inverse function. So 0. Sorry. So 0, this is 1 and here it is minus 1, pi by 2, it is reverse, domain and range will be reverse for the function. This is pi, 3 pi by 2 and next it is 2 pi. So like this we will get, that is 3 pi by 2. This is the graph for the inverse function. If we combine these two, so we will get like this. So that is the combination. This is the inverse of that function. So if we look, so if we take that, if we bring like this and if we keep, that is the reverse of this. It is the reverse model. It is the ulta model. So that is the ulta. So we will get that is the so inverse of inverse and other the reverse another. This graph name model hing aiti adna hing maadibitte andre so at that time so that is the inverse of the trigonometry reverse model. So that is nothing but the inverse trigonometry function. So this is the graph for the sine. Similarly we study about that is a cos inverse also. First we come to know what cos. It is r to minus 1 to 1. So the graph of this function. So here we have to discuss about the inverse of this function. To study the inverse of this function means it should be both 1-1 and 1-2. So whether it will become a 1-1 or 1-2 or not we have to check. So for that first we'll see that sine will take two different values, whether in the real number it will become a 1-1 or not, we have to check. So let me select that is cos pi by 3. So cos pi by 3 means cos 60. Cos 60 means 1 by 2. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. So next cos minus pi by 3. Minus pi by 3. Or we can also write that is two different cos minus pi by 3. It is also 1 by 2. So two different. Pi by 3 is different. Minus pi by 3 is different. But their values are same. So means here it is clear our cos function is not 1-1. If it is not 1-1 means it is not a invertible. If it is not a invertible, then how can we study that is a inverse trigonometric function? So then what we have to do? We have to make the restriction for our domain. The problem is here in the domain. So for that, what we have to do? So how to identify? What we have to do for that interval to identify better way? So plot the graph for that function. So two different value, but we have got the same image. For that reason, it is not a 1-1. So if it is not a 1-1, means it is not enough. We have to make some adjustment in the domain of the given function to make it as a 1-1 function. To make it as a 1-1 function. So for that, we'll plot the graph for the sine cos function. Adukke en madodre cos function ge graph hakkodu. So graph of the cos function enaitre andre 0, that is pi by 2. So next, so pi, 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi. Next, ikade bari minus pi by 2, minus pi, minus 3 pi by 2, minus 2 pi, minus 2. That is 1 and here it is minus 1. So 0 is the 1 agutre. Cos 0 andra 1, 90 andra 0 ili 1, pi andra minus 1 agutre, 3 pi by 2 andra 0, 2 pi andra 1. Graph of e tara bartetre idaru graph. So graph of the cos function. So cos function 1-1 ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಹುಡುಕಬಹುದು. ಏನಿಲ್ಲರಿ, ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಒಂದು ಲೈನ್ ತೆಗೀರಿ, ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಒಂದು ಲೈನ್ ತೆಗೀರಿ, ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ 1-1 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ. 1 ಈ ಮೈನಸ್ ಫೈವ್ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಫೈವ್ ಬೈ ಟೂ ತಗೊಳಕ್ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ರಿ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ. 1-1 ಆಗಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿ, 0 ಟು ಪಾಯ್, ಪಾಯ್ ಟು 2 ಪಾಯ್ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಒಂದೊಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. 0 ಟು ಮೈನಸ್, ಸೊ ಮೈನಸ್ ಪೈ ಟು 2 ಪೈ, ಒಂದೊಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇರಬೇಕು ನಮ್ದು. ಸೊ ಕಟ್ ಆಗಿ, ಸೊ ಈ ಇಂಟರ್ವಲ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು, ಇದು 1-1 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಇಂಟರ್ವಲ್ ನಾಗ ಈ ರಿಯಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಲೈನ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಮಾತ್ರ 1-1 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಹೆಂಗ್ರಿ, 0 ಟು ಪೈ, ಪೈ ಟು 2 ಪೈ, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಇಂಟರ್ವಲ್ ದಾಗ ನಾವು ಒಂದೇ ಇಂಟರ್ವಲ್ ತಗೋತೀವ್ರಿ. ಅದು ಯಾವ್ದ್ರಿ, 0 ಟು ಪೈ, ವಿಚ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಅವರ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಕಾಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ 0 to pi, 0 to pi 2, minus 1 to 1, minus 1. So now this function becomes both 1-1 and 1-2. If it is both 1-1 and 1-2, then it is invertible. If it is invertible, then it has its inverse. The inverse of cos is defined like this, that is minus 1 to 1 to 0 to pi. So where 0 to pi is called as a principal branch range. Principal branch range. If any function lies within this range, for that we call it as a principal value of the given function. Principal value. Idukka principal branch. So hanga sine range principal branch. So minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Cos range 0 to pi. So it is a clear. It is called as a principal branch range. So we have so many ranges of the cos inverse, but this is called as a principal branch range. Sometimes they may ask for 1 mark, what is a principal branch range, that is 0 to pi. If suppose simply they ask the range, you can write 0 to pi or pi to 2 pi or pi 2 pi to 3 pi, 4 pi, like this you can write that. But when they ask that is a principal branch range, so this is. So this is about the cos inverse x. Cos inverse x is minus 1 to 1 to. So let me study about its inverse graph. Graph of this function. Inverse graph of this. So the inverse graph is like this. 0, that is pi by 2, minus, minus pi, minus 3 pi by 2, then minus 2 pi. So pi by 2, 3 pi by 2 2. So here 0 to 90 it is 0. So if cos is 0 that it will become a 1 0, then it is a minus 1, here it is minus 1, and 0 then plus 1. The graph of this function will get like this. So this is the inverse graph of the cos inverse x. So it is a normal function and it is an inverse function. Simply, that is a reverse of this. That is nothing but the reverse of this is called as an inverse function. Inverse function. So this is about the cos. Next we move to that is a tan. Functioning from its domain is r minus n pi plus 1, sorry, 2n plus 1 pi by 2, where n belongs to z, 2 real number. So it is a domain of this function and its range is real number. So now we have to verify whether it will become a 1 1 or not for a function. Let me check that is. So we'll take that is tan pi by 4 is equal to 1. What is the value of tan? Tan pi by 4 is 1. Next, tan 5 pi by 4, tan 5 pi by 4, it is also 1. So, two different value, we got the same image. Different value, got the same image. So, it is not a 1 1. So 1 1 means different value, different image, then we say our function is 1 1. But here tan pi by 4 and tan 5 pi by 4, they are different. So pi by 4 is different, 5 pi by 4 is different, but their images are same. If their images are same, then the function is not a 1 1. If the function is not a 1 1, means so how can it become an invertible? It is not an invertible. If it is not an invertible, then its inverse is not exist. But if inverse is not exist, how can we study the inverse of the tan function? So for that reason, we have to restrict our, so that is the domain. We have to restrict our domain. So of the tan function, what we have to do to restrict our domain? So let me start with the graph and then we come to know where we have to restrict. So how to restrict that? So at which interval it will become a 1 1? Through the graphically we can analyze and we conclude that. So how to restrict? What is the restriction of the domain of the tan function? So it is 0, then pi by 2, here minus pi. I'll take this much only. So then minus 5, here it is pi. I'll take this much. So I'll not extend the graph for this function. So 0, tan 0 is 0, tan 90 is, so that is infinity, positive infinity, and it is a first quadrant. So that it goes like this. We dotted. For a quadrant, we dot the shaded line for the quadrants. like this. Like this we will do. So this is infinite. So it is opposite to this. First quadrant is a positive and it is opposite to, like this we get granted. And similarly, if pi by 2 to pi, it is a second quadrant. Second quadrant, in the second quadrant, it is a negative. 90 is a 0. Negative means it comes like this. Comes like this one.